हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग क्लास 9 चैप्टर 1 एंड 2 एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चंस पार्ट ए एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल। एंड इन एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल चैप्टर 1 इज अवर कम्युनिकेशन स्किल। ओके, सो चैप्टर 1 इज अवर कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स। सो आई वांट टू डिस्कस एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन ऑफ अवर बुक। So you can see self assessment. Okay, so first is MCQ questions. Okay, which of the following is not a characteristics of communication? So you can see, so it may not lead to any response or reaction. Okay, so communication is our exchanging information. Okay, it is a social activity, but it is not led to any response or reactions. Okay, so reaction is not a characteristics of communication. Verbal communication comprises, in verbal communication you can see written or spoken message, any message that use words. So in verbal communication you can use words, and written or spoken message you can use in verbal language. In non-verbal communication can be unspoken, okay, without spoken, without speechless. So we can say this is our non-verbalization communication. According to Dr. Albert Mehrabian, one of the pioneers in the field of body language, spoken words account for what is listener perceives. So you can see 7%. Okay, according to Dr. Albert Mehrabian, one of the pioneer in the field of body language, so we can say spoken words account for 7% of what listener perceives. Okay, next, multiple choice question of our chapter 1. The word communication comes from the Latin word communis, which means to share, which means to share. Two-way communication takes place when, so two things we will include: there is a person who send a message, and there is another person who reply to the sender. So two things you can say in a two-way communication. The two-way communication can be, you can say, multiple if the transferring thoughts, feelings, emotions and information sharing is not done with a common group of understanding. So we can say, so two-way communication can be multiple, okay, if the transferring thoughts, feelings, emotions, information sharing is not done with a common ground of understanding. Okay, one-way communication is become the sender does not have to deal with the potential question of disagreement from the receiver. So faster is easier, slow and steady, important and serious. So we can say, so in fourth question, one-way communication is, the answer of fourth question is important and serious. The answer of third question is, it is very important and serious. Okay, so important and serious, this is the right answer. Multiple choice question of chapter 1, communication may fail because of, you can see the several reasons. One of the reason is individual own personal discomfort, barriers that result from performance characteristics and limitations such as memory, concentration and mental sharpness. This is the way, so will communication may fail. Individual mental blocks may cause, you can say, visual perceptions. Okay, individual mental blocks create this type of problem, visual perception. The word that communicate best are usually those that are, you can say, words that will increase the receiver vocabularies. Okay, word power, we can say, when you have in our mind words of any particular language, so our communication power will improve. So words that will increase the receiver vocabulary. Now, self-assessment of chapter 1, choosing appropriate, okay, this is our English written skill questions. So we can say appropriate words and phrases is important to convey ideas in the form of message is very important in written communication. The lack of clarity of sentence in expressing idea may lead to failure of any written communication. So clarity of sentence will create problem. Effective writing skill is the product of long hours of thinking and practice. Effective written skill require a lot of thinking practice. And this is our exercise question of our chapter 1 MCQ. It varies significantly from place to place, village to small towns to big cities. So we can say eye contact. Eye contact is very, very different from place to place. A message should not be sent if channel is not suitable. Okay, if channel have some kind of problem, so message should not be sent. Which of the following indicate to sender that his or her message has been received by receiver? So we can use feedback. So that feedback indicate to sender that his or her message has been received by receiver. For a successful communication, it is important that the sender keeps his message free from prejudice or complexity. Our message always free from prejudice and complexity. If is a collection of related sentences dealing with a single topic. So we can say a paragraph is a collection of related sentences dealing with a single topic. It shows the action. When action and existence, so we can say it is a verb. In English grammar, we can say any action or any activity, we can say verb in our English language. Okay. Now, this is our chapter 2 MCQ questions. You can see which of the following is not a self-management skills. Relational ability or personal quality, it is not a self-management skill. Okay. Now, which of the following show your ability to participate as a member of team? We can say interpersonal skill. Okay, interpersonal skill shows your ability to participate as a member of a team. Okay. Now, self-monitoring is the extent to which you base your behavior on cues from other people and situation. So self-monitoring is important, is the extent to which you base your behavior on the cues from other people and situation. General feeling of self-worth is known as, we can say, self-esteem. General feeling of self-worth is known as, we can say, self-esteem. Chapter 2 exercise question, you can see self-management skill do not involve manage inanimate object. Self-management skill don't manage inanimate objects. Okay, this thing you keep in mind. The three broad areas influenced by self-management skill do not include communication skills. Okay, three broad areas influenced by self-management skill don't include communication skill. Self-efficacy refers to the belief to your own ability to deal with events and challenge. So we can say self-efficacy refers to the belief your own ability to deal with event and challenge. Improve your self-management skill. So we can say build your confidence. Okay, so when you have good self-management skill, so you have a very good confidence. Okay, students. So these are our chapter 2 MCQ questions. So today I am discussing about chapter 1 and 2 MCQ question of internal and external. Hope this thing is very helpful to you. Okay, students, thank you so much.